running back son. He's really number one, too. Hello, we've got a full start. The little mascots are ready to go. No sign of Tim Kelly and the Rams. But the big Rams out. That's Rodney Randolph. And what a sight he is. He's got the boxing gloves on, too. They could come in handy in the grand final out there today. But still waiting for the Rams to come down the chute. The Tigers, well, they're nowhere to be seen, right over the other side of the field. And we did just have a minute's silence for Mrs. Hillier, mother of Rick, the referee who refereed the reserve grade, passed away in the early hours of this morning up at Darba. And we certainly send our condolences, or give our condolences to all of the Hillier family. Well, quite a pause before we get into the action, but I see a face coming down the chute now. No, I don't. There's a lot of expectation. I don't know where we're going to find our way up through that tangle of people, Paul.
There's a lot of people there, Brian.
Yeah, they might be jammed in. And there's so many people here today, I'll tell you what, they're queuing up at the toilet. We've got the toilet queue. Okay, we might take a break before we get to the grand final. Back in a moment with all the action in the first half. Yes, well, we've still got that expectation that something's going to happen soon. And we're still waiting for both teams to come on. The Tigers, we are no not there, but I can tell you they're right over the other side of the paddock there somewhere. They have a tent right over the eastern side of Olympic Park. And they're kept right away from proceedings. They were here today. They're under 16s on today. And they've had a quiet warm-up for this grand final. The Rams are in the dressing shed. And they're waiting for them to appear. I'd say they'd be getting last-minute instructions. And they would be to hang on in there for these first 10, 20 minutes when things will really be tough and rugged out there in the grand final. And Mark Gagler, we don't have any idea why the hold-up is.
Kenny's just psyching him up for this big appearance. I think the Rams are going to open this game up from the word go, McGee. She's going to be on.
You're starting to frighten me, mate, with all that strong talk. But you don't know why we're held up.
I don't know. Ronnie Lange is running around here. He's calling the teams out. I don't think anyone's going with the sheds to bring them out. Someone should go in there and say, it's game time, boys. Let's play the ball.
Here they come, fellas. Here they come. And Ken Kelly letting them out. And the under-14s are taking them out of the field. In fact, they're as much as high on the ball. Ken Kelly, Chris Cummings, Nick McCullough, John Taylor is waking up from the left. There's Reggie Reynolds, Greg Creed, the second row, what a busy job out there today. Michael Howard, Shane Haynes, there's Greg Geard, big man up to him. Only a youngster, forced his way to the first grade this year, and now he finds himself into a grand final. The Rams are on the field, and Taylor said it's tougher. The Tigers, too, they've slipped on from the other side, and they're calling their usual huddle. In centre, and I would certainly appreciate having heaps away from the front of us. We're not even going to get a view of the game. This is ridiculous. We'll be lucky to see anything. Well, there's the Tigers. I haven't said too much about them yet. I'm probably not going to. But here comes the... seem to be terribly significant at this stage, Paul. It was a lot stronger earlier today.
No, it has died down a bit.
The drizzling rain has certainly gone. There was only just a few spots here. We couldn't even call it a drizzle. And now the start of the grand final about to get underway. 21 minutes past three. We're a little bit late. But there goes Jason Phelps. Picks it up. It's coming down to Cummings. They're kicking out. On it goes to Kelly. Kelly is on the charge. Taken down on the 22. He'll play it for the first time in the game. Back to Howard. To Hume. They've got a drive around. Baker stopped in his tracks just outside the 22. And that's where he'll play it. 24 metres out from his own line. Back it comes to the kick to Turner. Turner puts it over. Finds the nowhere land. The Clark running back will take it just inside his own half. He'll run it over halfway before he'll be put down there by Howard. Play back to Margus. Margus decides to run himself, pushes Howard away, and will be held up about 13 metres inside the Ram half. Back it comes to Jones. Jones crashes at the Ram pack. He's pulled down about 36 metres out from the Ram line. Giffini. On it goes to Daniels. To Huddleston coming, sitting back in field, but he's well taken in the tackle by Chris Cumming. Back to Feeney. Feeney gets to the Phelps. Phelps well taken down, 32 metres out, and the referee's whistle has gone. Not on.
Forward pass, mate, yeah.
And first gun of the match. Muswellbrook will have the feed. Guess what'll happen? They'll win it. Back it comes to Turner. Turner gets it away to Bartholomew. Bartholomew steps and goes, but he's well wrapped up by Bear Logan, who breaks from the scrum very quickly. Daniel's there to help him. Out to Turner on the blind side. On it goes to Peed. Crunching tackle from Harrison, and Bear Logan to put him down. 34 metres out from the Muswellbrook line. Back to Hume. On it goes to McKellar. McKellar's really hit hard. A slogging tackle from Douglas to put him down. Back it comes to Hume. Baker charges heavily and stops dead where he gets into the tackle of Wilton and Jones. And he'll fly 12 metres short of halfway. Cummings gets away to Turner. Turner gets it back to Peed. Peed gets it back to nobody. It's a loose ball floating backwards. And it'll be picked up by Reggie Reynolds. Reynolds can't get away from his, from the tackle of Bear Logan. He'll play it about 3 metres out.
Way back to go too, Brian.
Six to go for Muswellbrook. It was played through by Aberdeen, or top favourite. But McKellar can't get away from his own line either. He's taken down by Douglas. Douglas into the action early. Back it comes now to Bartholomew. Lobs it over the top to Haynes. He starts. So he stops, gets back inside, gets the ball back to Cummings. Cummings throws it to Howard. On it goes to Turner. To Bates, and the ball runs into a bit of space. The trunk goes under him to put him down. 32 metres out from the Muswellbrook try line. Back to Turner. Turner kicks again. And looking for the touchline this time. Clark trying to pull it in. And as a matter of fact, it still eventually does go into touch. Really took a very good ball.
It'll be interesting to see which way the referee rules. I know he's going to evidence feed.
It is the Aberdeen feed. I don't think it'll be it. Reggie Reynolds been getting some attention after that good run. That's the best run of the game so far. Out it comes to Daniels. Aberdeen have won the scrum. Get away to Harbert. There's room here. Harrison crunches in the clear. Comes to Reynolds. Steps inside Reynolds. And Reynolds will take him down. One lead is inside by Muswellbrook half. Back it comes to Harrison. He makes 6 metres. Three pulls him down, but he gets the ball away. It's got McCready to McGrath. The car first up the centre. That will be pulled down by Howard. And he'll play it back to Feeney. Feeney gets away to Douglas. Douglas is up towards the 22, and that's where he'll play it. Play back to Milkshake Milton. Milton, run by himself, pulled down, gets up and goes again, but he'll be taken down eventually by Hayne. Back it comes to Jones. Jones up the middle, and will be pulled down about 15 metres out from the line. What do you reckon they'll do here? Go for a bomb, or will they put up the kick? No, they're going to run it, and they've dropped it too. It's picked up by Feeney, but he'll unload it. Back to Clouse. Clouse will put the kick up. It's a shocker, and it's coming almost straight down. It'll bounce back to the Tigers. Daniels will put another one up, and they'll all be offside for this one. It looks as though it could go over the dead ball line, and that will be a 22 tap.
The game is at a crackerjack pace at the moment. It looks like Dennis Singleton, geez, I'll get the team right in a minute. Aberdeen's defence, it's wonderful at the moment, but just early on then when Muswellbrook were throwing the ball around, they did find a few holes out wide.
Yes, and from the tap, it's gone from to Turner. Turner is trying to weave his way through. It's caught in the tackle of Margaret, and that's where he'll play it, just outside the 22. Howard gets it across now to Kelly. Kelly's taken in the tackle of Phelps. Just outside the 22, not making any ground yet. Cummings on to Hume. They're certainly pushing the ball right. Peed. And that's to Moody. Moody's in a break. He's got to the penalty. Now it's moving through one. And he's kicked over the top. He's knocked over the
top. He's going to
be a penalty.
He's got Moody
up. And he's penalised. Right, well, only about 3 metres to the left of the post. They'll be having a go at the 2 points here, but that looked pretty good for the Rams. Nil all in the grand final after just 5 minutes of play.
Tracks. The second generation GTI leaves them standing. See the range of GTI Suzuki Swifts at Teasdales and Singleton. The Suzuki Swift 1.3 four-door sedan is spacious and has remarkable fuel economy. Offer pure quality inside and out. This is the Suzuki Swift Sedan 1.6. Both these outstanding vehicles are available in manual or automatic and are as exciting to look as they are to drive. See them now at Teasdales and George Street, Singleton. 3-0 in the grand final to Muswellbrook, sideline by McGrath.
Shane Hayne put it over. There's not too many chances you should give him. And that was a dead set penalty. Moody, great work. He got the break. And he was away. Phelps to kick off. Puts it down deep. Bates has got it. Inside his own try line. Gets it back to Kelly. Kelly runs strongly. Well taken in the tackle though by McGrath. He'll play it about 15 metres out. Howard gets it to Hughes. On it goes to Baker. Baker again stops in his tracks. Good strong tackle from Phelps. Back to Howard. He'll run from dummy half. Tries to run around Douglas. Douglas takes him down. Margaret's over the top. And he'll play it just short of the 22. Back to Cummings. Cummings gets it away to Hume. Hume on to Turner. Turner throws the dummy. Still looking to get it wide. Does get it wide. It's not a good pass. Huddleston will go through and knock McKellar over. Only about 5 metres out from the Muswellbrook line. Moody tries to run. Huddleston will wrap him up too, along with Milton. Now back it comes to Howard. He'll run from dummy half. And he'll be wrapped up by Milton and Logan. Still short of the 22. Muswellbrook having trouble running it away. Back it comes, it's time to feed. Douglas has got him covered, puts him down.
Logan and
there's a bit of fisticuffs going. Here Cummings running over the 22, but he'll be knocked over by McGrath and finished off by James. Back it comes to Turner. There'll be the kick here. There's a fight going on in the background. Tell you about it later. Here's Clark fielding the kick. Just throws it inside the line. In fact, it's been ruled as being over the line. I think he might have been ruled as stepping into the touch. What did you think, Paul?
That's what the referee has ruled.
And we'll now have a report on the fisticuffs. Well, Paul Giro, you probably saw every blow. What happened?
No, there wasn't much in it really, Ryan. It was just a bit of push and shove.
Howard and Logan, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Michael Howard and Bill Logan. Yeah. What happened?
Yeah, nothing in it. McGee, this fella's come in for no reason at all.
Who come in for no... Oh, you mean the touch shot. Right. Yep. Right, we'll see what action will be taken here. It hasn't much of a wanted penalty way back here. Aberdeen wouldn't mind having one if it went that way. But it'll be the scrum to pack down. And Muswellbrook certainly have come out in this game to move it wide. They're not going to play at Aberdeen's forwards, are they? That's what they're going to do.
No,
and they're going to kick.
Yeah, Brian, they've sent a few holes out wide.
And I'm not a great believer in centre-aside defences, Paul. Aberdeen have used that for a number of years now. It's been very successful for them. But it does have its fall downs, I think, at times. And a penalty to Muswellbrook. And oh, what's he playing to the head for? The use of the head in going down, was it?
No, he didn't bend in.
Didn't give a loose head, what?
I don't know.
Loose head, yeah. Yeah. Hayne will kick the touch. There's no kick of goal, of course, with a scrum penalty. Differential. Muswellbrook have an excellent opportunity here to attack. And to take hold of this game. Back it comes to Hayne. Hayne runs. Goes down pretty easily in the tackle of Jones. It'll be played back to Howard. On to Kelly. Kelly tries to squat his way through. But Douglas is underneath him to take him down. About 15 metres out. Howard this time switches it to Cummings. Cummings will try and get it away, but he's wrapped up. Still about 15 metres out. They're saying hello to their own coach and their old coach, the Tigers. Here, out it comes down to Turner. Turner, a big pass out to Moody. Moody just outside Huddleston, but can't go on with it as they catch him up to him. Bear Logan coming across terrifically in cover to put him down. Back it comes out from Turner to Hume. On to Bates. Bates gets the big pass away. On it goes to Cummings. Cummings is held and put to ground. Cummings looks a little bit awkward at that time. Back it comes to Bartholomew, a field goal defence.
Oh,
I think it's there. 5-0, Muswellbrook lead after 11 minutes of play in the grand final.
Don't be left in the cold this winter. See Elgas at Muswellbrook. They'll keep you cosy and warm with convenient bodied Elgas. Their full range of clean, economical room heaters include Runner, Pyrox and Overdura in sizes to suit your room and decor. Elgas will come to your home and do a free measuring quote for the heater that's best suited to your needs. Discover the convenience and efficiency of gas heating by calling to Elgas in Bridge Street Muswellbrook Showroom or one of their local Elgas distributors.
Want to phone up a takeaway for dinner?
No, I think we'll stay home and have a garlic clove, a lemon sprinkled with soy flour and wheat germ all in a butter and watercress sauce.
What?
Well, I think we're not getting adequate vitamin intake in our diet. So, I'm trying to choose something from every food group.
I know what we can have. Synovus multivitamin and mineral tablet.
It's easy to care for your health and budget with Synovus vitamins.
Synovus vitamins. They sound good.
Yeah. Now, what sounds good for dinner?
Sonova Vitamins, available from supermarkets and selected pharmacies.
Three mil in the grand final to Muswellbrook in Sydney. It's 2-0 to Penrith. He's fine.
And the whistle's gone. Aberdeen has kicked off. And I missed all that looking around.
Ken Kelly against Dave Phelps to push him over.
This looks like it'll be a penalty to the Tigers. It's in a pickable range. Jason Phelps, as David White called there a while ago, has been around here practicing. And I believe he's got he had a few kinks signed out of his kicking by Gordon Keller. So we'll see if that's all going to take place. But a pretty lively and a fast start to a grand final. It's not the usual bit. Oh, we lost Mark Gagler.
I'm here again, yeah. Mate. So I think the Muswellbrook best thing plays where Moody, he's getting the outside of Huddleston. Aberdeen will have to watch that. Twice he's got on the outside of Huddleston and made good breaks. That's where Aberdeen are strong in the centre, but our wide Muswellbrook are finding their weaknesses.
Did he go to that ball?
Exactly right.
Yeah. As Muswellbrook probably decided they're going to bypass. They're doing a Norman Schwarzkopf. They're not going to go straight up the middle. They're going to go around the flank. Done it pretty well so far. Let's see how it goes for the full stretch of time.
Johnny Turner's been cutting that player out to give the ball out to Middies, who has been getting up the outside of Hudlow.
Bill Logan's cover has been good, though. It's cleaned up most situations. Now, Jason Phelps has this ball placed, and this is probably, as David White said, is going to be a vital part of this game. Aberdeen are really in trouble with their kicking. They'll be in trouble in this game, that's for sure. He's certainly put some concentration into it. He's named Matthew Ridge, the old Phelpsy, but they'd like him to be a bit for them today. He's hit it pretty well. It's 2 points. So much of it's 2. Aberdeen 2. 13 minutes gone in the 1991 grand final.
The Prince of Wales Tavern is the place to be this weekend for the post-grand final celebrations. No matter how your team fares, you'll be looked after at the Prince. The Prince of Wales have excellent facilities, a fantastic selection with affordable prices at the bistro, and most of all, a great atmosphere. And while the guys at the Prince might have one blue eye and one gold eye, they wish all the players the best of luck. Have a great weekend at the Prince of Wales this weekend, and go the Rams!
Aberdeen strike back now, 3-2 in the grand final.
And they're running it away from their own quarter. This is Huddleston now with the ball. He's taken it up almost to the 32-metre mark. That's where he'll play it when he's put down the tackle by Turner. Back it comes to McGrath, beats Turner's tackle. Can't get away from Baker. Baker will put him down. Just 11 metres short of halfway. Back it comes to Ben Daniels. He's put the kick in. It's beautifully taken by Hayne over his shoulder. Now he'll run it up. Does he put the pace on? No, he'll stop. And down he goes in the wall of Tigers. 10 metres on the Ram side of halfway. McKellar gets it away to Cummings. Cummings doesn't look to be running clearly to me at all at this stage. And he's down in the tackle of Phelps. Back it comes to Howard. To Hume. Heed. Heed runs strongly. Well tackled away by McGrath. Had his ankles taken right out from underneath him. Back it to Howard. Kelly. Kelly puts the run in. McGrath's hanging in there to put him down too, along with the help of Jason Phelps, and they'll track it in just inside the Aberdeen half. Now back to Hume, Turner, shows a little dummy, and but not taken by Jones, but a good strong run by Turner, taking him 8 metres inside the half. McKellar, back to Hume on the six, he's put the kick up, it's a beauty. Daniels is back there for it, and why is he back there, and where's Mickey Cleese? What's going on? That's Daniels makes a good wing. Run, he's thrown a loose ball. Picked up by Huddleston. Back it comes to French. French going via the cape. And he's being chased by Moody, who will eventually scrub him to the ground. And just try and pick up where Mick Cleese is, will you, mate? And back it comes to McGrath. McGrath runs it up. Heed will throw him to the ground. About 28 metres out. Back it comes to Milton. Feeney. Feeney reverses on the blind to Bear Logan. Logan runs it up. To within 10 metres of the halfway mark. Now Milton, the dummy half, throws it back to Feeney, Douglas, Daniels. Daniels has a lot of defence on him, so does Margaret when he gets. Now Huddleston. Huddleston tries to get flies over halfway. Eventually he'll be claimed in the tackle by Howard. 10 metres inside the Muswellbrook half. That was good stuff for Aberdeen. Here, Margaret goes to dummy half, elects to run himself, put down about 33 metres out. from the Muswellbrook try line. There's Cluse now getting it away to Feeney. They put the kick up, and Aberdeen really not chasing through on it. Bates has plenty of time to take it, and he'll be tackled, though, in a good strong tackle by Logan, 20 metres out from the Muswellbrook line. Way back to Hayne, gets it to Cummings, looked a bit freer that time, but never got far, as Douglas went under him, and Jones over the top. Howard this time gets it to Hume. Hume looking for the pass to Baker, gets it away to Baker, but Baker again is well wrapped up by Margaret, and he'll play it about 36 metres out to his own line. Howard, running by himself, runs into plenty of target offence. He'll play it 32 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Back to Turner, good kick from Turner. This one is an awkward bounce again for Clark. He lets it hit him on the foot, bounces behind him, has to drive on it as Hayne comes flying through. It's a knock on, he's ruling. Oh, I didn't see the knock on.
Yeah, it's fair enough too, Brian.
Right, I thought he'd let it go to his foot. Anyway, so Muswellbrook, through their kicking game, are keeping pressure on the Tigers. Tigers have just rucked their way out of that. They made good ground. They haven't really been in a good position. They've won the scrum as well, but the referee wants it put in again. Don't know why. Muswellbrook will win it anyway, so I don't see what the use of that is. And it's coming back to Muswellbrook, to Hume. He'll get it away to Turner. Bartholomew, wrap around to Turner. Bates up in the line. The Tomato Rolls. What a running play. Bench tried to push him off, and he kept going, but Cluse was there to wrap him up along with Logan. And now it's played back to Bates. Bates decides to run himself. Can't get through Huddleston, but he's only about 26 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Big attack to Bates.
That was
good.
That was good.
And that's what the referee said. A bit of a mix-up there. And Baker might have made a few more yards out of that run if he'd have been let go. Feeney to feed the scrum. Score remains 3-2. As it comes back now to Feeney. Feeney elects to run himself. He's been caught by, I guess it's Hume, can't see. Or Cummings has got him, so is Kelly. They got out of there quick. Second comes to Daniels. On to Margaret. Margaret to Huddleston. Huddleston still standing up in the tackle. Eventually thrown to ground by Cummings and also by McKellar. This time it's Milton getting it away to Phelps on the blind side. Phelps makes good ground, up to 11 metres from halfway, and Rams are offside. So there's a chance for the Tigers to pick their way onto the attack. Rams still leading by 3 points to two. The Tigers, there is a crazy advantage of the breeze, but I really don't think it is an advantage. Is it, Mark, the breeze?
It's dropped away remarkably in this late in the game. It's more of a cross breeze.
Yeah, I don't think we can count it really. So it's not a factor. Now they take the tap, and it's Daniels brought down about 8 metres inside the Muswellbrook half. Played back to Clark. Clark elects to run himself, and will make good ground too. He's about 36 metres out from the try line. Back it comes to Feeney. McGrath crunches into the defence, and he's pulled down 32 metres out. Back it comes to Feeney. Now to Douglas. Douglas runs on strongly and will be pulled down 24 metres out. They're making ground. Now it's a long pass out to Daniels. On it goes to Margaret. There's too much defence there for them though, I think. And Margaret will be taken to ground, still 24 metres out. Now the Tigers will be looking for a better kick this time. Here's Daniels. It's just a little chip over the top, and it's taken by Hayne, and he's taken by Milton, and he's lost the ball. And that is a knock-on. So the Tigers really do have a big chance here now.
That was a great chase by Jason Phelps.
And that looked like a bit of a planned manoeuvre. And maybe the Tigers have worked it all out at the moment. I think the Rams have had them a little bit nonplussed. They've won the scrum. Back it comes to Daniels. Cluse, bit of a line. Lines up Margaret. Huddleston's running with him. Margaret's running slowly though. He's only pulled down about 8 metres out. Good tackle from Ewan Bartholomew. Cluse. Huddleston's killed it. So too is Reggie Wells. It's fly away, comes back the other end. Look, McJake Milton is running slowly. Bounces off Baker, loses the ball. And it'll be fallen on by Baker. But the referee has said, we'll hold it up for the moment. And I don't know what he's going to rule. Looks like Baker is injured. There'll be some timeout now. Muswellbrook 3, lead Aberdeen 2, and we're 21 minutes into the 1991 Grand Final.
Two quick tries to Penrith. They lead North Sydney 12-0. This is the 1991 Group 21 Rugby League Grand Final from Olympic Park, Muswellbrook.
Steve Baker has made his way unsteadily to his feet. I think he has an injury somewhere around the hip area or in the back, in the small of the back.
He tapped an accidental knee in the back line.
Is that how it happened?
Yeah.
I missed that. I saw him hit the Aberdeen player off in the tackle. But it was a scrum to pack down. Muswellbrook speed of a scrum, so they'll be able to get away from this danger area. It's gone back to Hume. Turner. Stop. Start. Dummies. Not taken by Daniels, who puts him to the ground. But it comes to Hume. On to Bartholomew. Strong run. Gets the ball back. But it's loose. And will be fallen on by Howard, who's been had a good game so far in this match. It comes back to Hume. Now to Kelly. Kelly's taken well in the tackle by McGrath. Chopped right down about 18 metres out. Bear Logan's in trouble. And looks as though he has trouble there. And back it comes now to, that looks like big trouble for Bear Logan. It comes back to Turner. Turner kicks. He's found the open spaces here. Robert Trench not at home. Back it comes to Cruz. Cruz will make the run. And he's lost it. It's gone back to Reynolds. Reynolds can't get away, and the Tigers in trouble. They're a man down, and the Rams on the attack. 38 metres out. Hume. Out it comes to Cummings. Cummings a big one over to Haynes. Haynes put it on the deck, and that's a knock-on, says the referee. I don't like the look of Bill Ivan. Just even get a report on that for us.
The Lions are just going on the field now. They're going to stop play for
us. I think they should, and I think we should probably take a break here too. Rams 3, lead Muswellbrook 2. 24 minutes gone in the Rams 3, Aberdeen 2, I should say. 24 minutes gone in the Grand.
Bell Club's Link poker machines give you a greater chance to win. If you're not a member, join today and take advantage of your gold card membership. The Singleton RSL Club, supporting the community for a community chest. Proud sponsors of the Singleton Greyhounds, Singleton RSL Supersonics Basketball and Singleton Junior Soccer. This information for members and guests.
Good news for the Tigers, Troy Logan, their captain coach, back on his feet. He put his place in the scrum. It's still 3-2 though to Muswellbrook.
It's metres from halfway, Aberdeen in possession, back and goes to Finch. Finch gets it away to Margaret. Margaret steps, goes, gets up over the halfway before he's put down there by Baker. Good tackle. And back it comes to Wilton, on to Phelps, up the blind side. As that really runs, this is a beauty. He's gone right up to within 28 metres of the try line. And he's put him up that time as it comes back to Feeney. Feeney, a big pass to Cluse. On to Daniels. The Aberdeen centers don't seem at home. This one's back to Logan. Logan's up to the 22 before he's taken down by Kelly in the fifth tackle. So it's kick time. If Feeney doesn't kick, now he'll kick, chips over the top. It's not a bad one. Baker's made a mess of it. Feeney Tigers are into the play. Feeney has scored. A great little bit of work by Mark Feeney. And the Tigers hit the front. 6 points to 3 in the grand final. I'll have to stand up to get a look here. And Phelps, it's an important kick. They're all important in the grand final, Mark.
They're very important. Every point is very vital. Phelps will want to put this over for the Tigers.
6-3 they lead. And 8-3 would sound a lot better. Every point is vital the way this game's going. He's hit it, I think, away to the left. And that's the way it went. 6-3. And we'll Come back now to the halfway mark. Well, mate, Aberdeen probably are a little bit lucky to be that well off at this stage. Muswellbrook have looked good.
Well, so far they've been the better side, Aberdeen, but whenever Muswellbrook made a few breaks, we've gone up the other end of the paddock, they've got points on the board.
That's right. Aberdeen defence has been good. They've just been caught a little bit out wide. Now it's going to be Hayne. Puts the kick up. And it's going to be taken by Phelps on the fly. Strong run from Phelps. He's going to nearly bring it back to the halfway mark. That's good work. And the try got over there. Gets ready. Here comes Jones. He's got a pretty quiet one. And I'm having a bit of trouble seeing here. Back it comes to Jones. His tackle just over halfway. Back to Clark. Clark tries a little run up the middle, but he's well caught by Cummings, who anticipated having that go. 45 metres out from the line. Back to Feeney. Feeney out to Ben Daniels. On it comes to Margaret. Margaret steps to go back inside. McKellar will catch him in the tackle. McKellar's been pretty busy getting across in cover today. And Margaret will play it right on the halfway mark. Back it comes to Daniels. Daniels does a little step and away he goes. Gets the ball away to Feeney. Feeney shoots the pass out to Logan. Logan flying up the centre, but brought down about 32 metres out. And here's a chance for another bit of kicking action from Feeney. Puts it back inside to Daniels. And it's a third pass. And the fifth tackle will be taken about 32 metres out from the Muswellbrook line, right in centre field.
It was a good decision too.
Back to Howard. Yes, it was a fair decision. Back to Cummings. Feed. Leaves it out to Moody. French eventually will take Moody down. Still about 11 metres on the Muswellbrook side of halfway. Back to Cummings. Cummings caught, but gets the ball back to here. But it's an awkward pass. He picks it up, gets it back to Baker. Baker slams to the ground. Good tackle from Huddleston. McGrath coming in over the top. Back it comes now to Bartholomew. He's handed by McGrath. He's got the ball back. It's Turner trying to make a go for. Gets the ball away. He's tackled. Well, comes it, unloading the ball. Well, Cummings gets it away now to Kelly. It's gone out to Hayne. Hayne will put the kick and chase up. He's knocked over two, and this will be another penalty, I would suspect. And he's down touch. And what is it going to be a penalty, or what did Hayne just trip?
No, the linesman's on the field, Brian. He caught it.
I thought he came in contact with an Aberdeen player, and Jones is getting a caution. And it is a penalty to Muswellbrook. A chance for them to put one over. Aberdeen leading by 6 points to shoot. No, they're not going to take it. Hayne's going to put him to touch, and they say we can score a try here. And of course, there's about 10 minutes to go to half time as there's the tap. Hume, McKellar, back to Turner, onto Cummings. Cummings gets over to Peed. Peed makes a bit of a run inside the 22, but he's put down about 6, 17 metres out. And this will be another penalty. Oh no, he didn't penalise Margaret. He was looking the other way. Second comes to Turner. Turner tries to get on the outside. He's lost the ball forward, and that'll be a knock on. And Turner looking a bit upset with Douglas there. I think Douglas might have passed a few words to him. So scrum down centre field, only about 20 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Aberdeen has soaked the pressure up pretty well too.
Yeah, I reckon.
Yeah, they have. Danny wins it. And comes to Daniels. Charged down by Turner. And it will go into the touch on the full. Be another scrum. Aberdeen to two. So that could have been very dangerous. I thought he might. He might have ended up doing a Gary Coyne. Remember that try yesterday?
Yeah.
Mark Gagler doesn't want to remember it. Fed in by Feeney, he'll win it too. Gets it away to Daniels. Daniels runs it wide. He's thrown down by Turner. Pretty good battle between these two. Turner might be in front at the moment. Here comes Margaret. Margaret strongly up the centre. Running from dummy half. Clears to 22. Now it's out to McGrath. McGrath steps, goes back inside. He'll be held up by Howard. That brings it 34 metres out. A good down-gaining run. On it goes now to Huddleston. Huddleston has a bit of a juggle. Nearly lost it. And he'll be held up about 10 metres short of the halfway mark. So they're making ground, the Tigers. Second comes now to Daniels. Daniels will put the kick up. It's over the top of Bates. A good follow through by Cruz. But the ball will run dead in goal. And Muswellbrook will bring it up to the 22 to restart play.
Muswellbrook's defence is not working, Brian.
Yes, I'll certainly tell you what, though, Johnny Turner's magic's certainly working. Hayne's going to come up and kick and chase. The chase is on. Huddleston is going to win it. He's going to come back and get it. That was a surprise manoeuvre. Huddleston will step Hayne. Hayne will grab him and put it into the ground about 16 metres out. So that was a quick counter-attack from the Rams. But it's the Tigers who have possession of the ball. Clark, Feeney, back to Clark, pulls away from Haynes. But he's put down, loses the ball. It's picked up by Haynes. And the referee has ruled scrum. And I dare say it will be a Muswellbrook fee. So a chance for the Rams. Coming up to half time too, according to Mike Lock. We're about 7 minutes out. Wins first in, wins it. Referee wants it again. Turner was on his way there. Yoon puts it in. Comes out the other side of the scrum this time, but back to Turner anyway. On it goes to Cummings. Cummings pulls away from one, but can't get away from Bear Logan. It'll hold him up in the tackle. Also Jones there. Now to Yoon. Yoon will spin it wide. No, he'll be caught by Logan. A good standing tackle by Logan to get Hume out yonder there. Here's Turner running, puts it away to Baker. Baker's on the charge. He really had been seen up that time, but Huddleston will right into the ground 5 metres out. But it comes to Hume. Hume on to Kelly. Kelly is pulled down about 6 metres from the line, and the Tigers have their backs to the wall at the moment. Now Hume to Turner. A long one out to Cumming. Cumming holds it up to Kelly. And 4 metres into the
front
line, and
score
at the try.
Yes, and it's
the Rams who go back to the front. They're leading by 7 points to six, with about 7 minutes to go to half time. Yeah, it is a good bit of switching the play, moving that very wide again, Paul.
Well, Johnny Connell, Turner to start, Turner's pass out wide. He gave a beautiful pass out to Chris Cummings. And all Connell had to do is just give a little pass to Pete.
I think Turner's appreciating that bit of extra room he's getting out there today, Mark.
He's having a good game, Turner. You've got to give credit to Shane Hunt. He took that kick downfield, got in the field position. They won the ball from the start and they scored from it.
Here's the kick from Hayne. Looks all right. And now the action's back to halfway. So now the Tigers have got to come back. And right on the halfway mark, LLB stops the kickoff. Rams have had the better of the first half. Now it is reflected on the scoreboard. The kick comes to Turner, a rolling one along the ground, takes about 10 metres out. He'll be taken down in the tackle by Logan. About 18 metres out from the try line, now on to Baker. Baker's run strongly, almost 2 feet, on the way to Howard. And Howard's made good ground up to the 31 metres out from his own line. Now McKellar. McKellar stopped, hit the ground by Margots. Still about 31 metres out. Howard onto Hume. Hume gets it away to the big fella there in Bartholomew. Bartholomew tackle 34 metres out. Now it switches to the other side to Turner for the kick. Puts the kick through. And Cluse running back to it will pick it up. And he's got plenty of defence there. Reynolds will take him down about 8 metres, 11 metres short of the halfway. It's played back to Trench. And that penalty will have to go to the
charge
Reynolds wasn't out of the way.
That's a bit of a scary call. Robert Banks said that milk, that penalty.
Yeah, if he could have picked it up, you'd have reckoned. And it was the kick from, I couldn't see who kicked it, but we're down touch just on the halfway mark. That's the Tigers. Logan, on it comes to, back to McGrath, runs into the heap of the defence, and we'll go down. Loses the ball, and it will be a knock-on against McGrath, and Kelly's in a little snap there. Got the better of you. Too fine. And now it'll be here to third the scrum, so that Rams had a chance to go on the attack again. They get Turner, on it goes to Bates. Bates running across field, becomes an easy mark for the defence of Samuels, who are putting the ground 10 metres short of the halfway mark. On it comes. Cummings runs strongly, makes good ground too. He's running more fairly as the game goes on. Phelps will hold him up with the help of Margots. Now Howard, looking back to Hume. That's bad, so we've said that about 40 times here today. They've really got their options right. That one went on to Pede. He's down about 4 metres short of halfway. Now Howard, Hume, Turner. Out it comes now to Bartholomew. Tries to skirt wide, tries to get around. He's put the ball down. It's going to be picked up by Margots. And the Tigers have a chance to strike back before half-time. And it'll be played back to Milton, to McGrath. McGrath will run into Kelly. Kelly will put him down again, but McGrath made good ground about 32 metres out from the try line. French will go to the blind side, makes another 5 or 6 metres, about 36 metres out from the line now as it comes to Feeney. Daniels, Phelps standing wide, what can he do out here? He can't do very much. A very good tackle from Moody takes him out. Back it comes now to Daniels. Feeney looking for runners, there weren't any there on that occasion. He's pulled down just outside of the 22. Back to McGrath on the blind side. McGrath pulls out of one, comes to Cummings. It's a loose pass back. It's scooped back. Margaret will eventually pick it back. Pick it up. Hughes onto him. Dodges away from Hume. Still going, Margaret. Drops the pass back. It's down to Kelly. And Kelly will play it. Well, that was a bit loose. An ordinary play there. 36 metres out. The Muswellbrook ruins from their own line. Baker trying to take it up. He certainly put the work in the run-up today. And he's tackled 41 metres from the try line. That's from the Muswellbrook line. Back it comes to McKellar, running strongly onto the board. But tackled by Milton McGrath, 10 metres short of halfway. Back now to Hume, he'll reverse play. On to Bartholomew. Bartholomew's caught, but unloads the pass. It's picked up by Logan, and Bates will slam Logan to the ground. 36 metres out. Now Milton. Milton will run, looking for runners, but Aberdeen are hanging back at the moment. As it'll be Logan getting it away to Douglas. Douglas almost to a 22, but Cummings will, with the help of him, will put him on the ground.
Think Kelly's off the field.
Injured. There goes French in a run. He really took the pace on there and went over the 22. It was only about 18 metres out. But the Tigers are a man down at the moment. Who's down in the background?
Oh, McGrath.
Oh, good. Don't tell me. Okay, Daniels. Got a little dummy. Looks around for runners. But Bear Logan had run past him. And the Tigers seems to be running out of ideas here at the moment. Now Phelps, what can he do? He'll run in. Squeezes the pass away. It's an awkward run to Jones. Jones puts the kick up. There's a charge through for it. It's loose over the line. And Clark almost picked it up. But he's going to be ruled offside anyway. Anyway, McGrath's back on his feet. You sure that was McGrath? Yeah,
it was McGrath. Yeah. Actually, it looks like he did something to his arm. He's gone off the field, and it looks like he'll have it strapped. I'd say he'll be back on there.
I hope Scott McGrath didn't bite him and all that over there a while ago.
I just got word he broke his thumb, Brian.
Who can?
Ken Kelly.
Yeah, well, that's bad luck for him. He's going to find it hard out there. Anyway, let's relieve the pressure of the Rams. They got it about 27 metres out. Now Baker balling onto the ball again, but well tackled by Huddleston. Put down 36 metres out. Now it's Upton on the field. Upton's got to be tackled. 12 metres short of halfway. I don't think there was anything in that. It never went anywhere near his head. Anyway, there was a bit of serious talking going on here. The scoreboard says 9 points to 6 in favour of the Rams, and we're right on half time.
It's got back in Sydney, it's 12-6 in favour of Penrith, and here at Muswellbrook it's now 9-6 in favour of the Rams.
Coming up to half time too, and Hayne, the penalty goes to Muswellbrook from that little incident. Hayne picks up a towel, kick, and we'll find touch about 10 metres inside the Aberdeen half, maybe 12 metres. Now Howard onto Upton. Upton's got crunched down in the tackle, and the Tigers have been hit the ball inside the team. And there's a chance for him to put 2 more points on the board. This will be very, very handy. I'm sure they'll take them. Hayne's not there. Hayne is coming over. So they'll certainly take this kick. 9 points to 6. It's been a very good half for the Rams. They've certainly won the battle of the first 40 minutes. And I think we must be coming up to the break right now. We'll take a break. No, I'm missing the right thing. Yes, we will take a break. 9-6 the Rams lead with a kick to come.
Australians may not have much choice in home heating in the future. Harsh words? Well, with the depletion of the ozone layer and the greenhouse effect, many of today's popular methods, such as wood, coal, gas or oil that produce an open flame, could be banned. The alternative? Email Air Reverse Cycle Air Conditioning from Refrigeration Muswellbrook or Refrigeration Singleton. It's efficient and inexpensive, environmentally friendly, and keeps you warm in winter and cool in summer. Have your Email Air Reverse Cycle Air Conditioning installed with Refrigeration Muswellbrook or Refrigeration Singleton.
I'm lining up the kick. It's about 10 metres to the left of the upright. It's a pretty easy kick to Haney. He comes in, he's missed it. Well, I put the knocko on him, I think. So the score remains. Muswellbrook 9. Aberdeen 6. The Tigers to come back to a 22 dropout. And it'll be, I'd say, Feeney who'll take it. Tigers have got to regroup their forces in the second half, I feel. They've had some problems, particularly from Turner. It's a good kick down from Feeney, right down to Bates. Bates will take it. He'll run it up and be taken by Feeney. Feeney has put him down. Feeney gives him a little slap up the wrist as he goes. Nothing left him up. Up and put the ball on the ground. Here's a last-ditch chance for the Tigers. But Howard following through will put Milton down who picked it up on the halfway mark. Now a dummy from Daniels. Daniels is looking for runners and there's no one queuing up here at the moment. Now it'll be Milton. He'll get it away to McGrath. McGrath runs the line. He tries to step his way back in. Gets the pass back to Milton on against Logan. Logan goes up the centre. He found a hole. He's still going. No one there. A long way for Huda. And that takes us up to half time. Pretty good half for the first half for the Rams, as I told you. They're leading by 9 points to 6 over the Tigers in the 1991 Grand Final. And another 40 minutes to decide this Grand Final. I think the fair comment about the first half is that a change is there, Paul.
Paul Smith on the side, in the field there, Brian.
I think it could be Trevor James that's off. Jason Phelps there. Yeah, Jason Phelps is there. So Trevor James is off the field at the moment. Paul Smith. And you can look to Paul Smith to turn it on out there today.
Everybody back, please, on the edge, the side of the ground, back to the sign.
I think whoever's going to score first in this second half, have a big bearing on the winner here today, too, Brian.
Particularly if it's Muswellbrook. If Muswellbrook can put up an early try, they're really, the Tigers are really in trouble. Hayne will open proceedings. With big kick. Feeney's getting under it, takes it well. Back and goes to Logan. Logan's going to take the defence on, go through Moody. A crashing run from Logan. Takes it out about 26 metres. Well, that's the sort of start they wanted. Milton gets the pass away. No, takes it himself. Goes up to it to the 32 metre mark before he's put down by Upton. Play back to Logan. Phelps. Phelps will have to figure in the second half. He's run straight into Cummings. Cummings will drag him down. I've got the feeling that Cummings is not fully fit, but he's still playing a good part in this game. Now Smith. Smith steps back inside Cummings. Makes a good break. Up to within 7 metres of the halfway mark before he's tackled and brought down by Upton. Now Milton to Daniels. Daniels with it. And he's bisected and didn't quite bisect him. Bates picked it up on the bounce. He'll be taken down by Cluse. Held up in the tackle by Cluse. Douglas is underneath him. Play back to Hume. It's an awkward run, but Hume will get the pass away to Moody. Moody looks for a gap up the middle, but it closes as it's Smith who dives down to take him. Back now to, well, there's more traffic here than Pitt Street in front of us at the moment. It takes life hard. It looks like it's Creed taken down by McGrath. Now back to Hume, Turner, and Upton will be dragged down by Margaret, right on the halfway mark. Muswellbrook just taking it easily at the moment. Now Turner. Puts the kick over the top, and French will let it go into touch. Thought he might have been able to get under that one, Paul.
I think he was in two minds, Brian, whether he should take it on the full or let it bounce.
Yeah, well, I always reckon he's on the full or third to take.
And Brian, just a quick word from Gary Milton, the strapper for the Aberdeen side. He says there's no injuries, but a bit of blood on their guys, but it's probably Muswellbrook.
Well, that's wishful thinking, I think. That's an Aberdeen scrum. Daniels, Margaret. Margaret runs to Bartholomew. Bartholomew takes him well in the tackle. The blood back to Daniels. Daniels decides to run himself, going across field. Pops the pass to Phelps. Phelps well tackled by Creed. That was a good tackle. Played back now to Daniels. Daniels will get it away to Feeney. Feeney runs into into Cummings. That's not a good option. He's pulled down 32 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Back it comes to Douglas. Douglas will make a couple of metres, about 34 metres now. Baker and McKellar brought him down. Now Logan makes a good run to it within 10 metres of halfway. It's kick time. Feeney gets it under pressure, but puts it out to Daniels. Daniels gets a high kick up. It's coming down for Reynolds. He will take it well, just short of the halfway mark. A good take for the young fellow. And he ends up about 8 metres inside the Aberdeen half. That was a bit of good play for Muswellbrook. Then it comes to Feed. Feed will be taken down by Douglas. My word, Dave Douglas has put in a sterling defensive effort out there today. As it comes back to Hume, Turner, Baker balling on. The tackle by Margaret and also by Merton. Brought down 10 metres inside the Aberdeen half. Now Howard tries a run from dummy half. Swallowed up in the tackle of Merton. Crashed down by McGrath over the top. Back to Cummings at dummy half. Hume, Turner. Turner logs one over for Upton. Upton sees it right back. Goes forward, gets it back to McKellar. McKellar will be spun to the ground. About 26 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Going through to Rams on the sixth tackle. Getting on the attack. Hume, a chip over the top. Well taken by Feeney. But he in turn is taken by Hume and by Cummings. Inside his own 22. 18 metres out. Margaret couldn't find a runner. But Cummings finds him. Puts him to ground. He'll play it. Back to Clark. Clark runs clear of the dummy half. And he finally loses the ball forward. And with a strike creeping in, Aberdeen in trouble as Baker runs away from the ball. And he runs from Baker has scored. And Lucky will go to the lead. Gathering points tickets in the grand final. Hain, Hain will go in for the try. A great try to the Rams. Baker has scored. Hain has scored. And Lucky will go to the lead. 13 points to 6 in the grand final.
It was. I should change mind of course, but Baker made a great run there.
It was a great run by Baker. There wasn't much on. He went and threw the ball that was knocked forward by the winger Wayne Clark. Clark being carried off, getting helped off the field at the moment. So back to that, Baker, there wasn't much on. He raced back and picked the ball up, beat a couple of defenders before giving a really nice pass out to Shane Hain, and he had just a little bit too much pace for Ben Denyer to come across and just couldn't quite get him, and he scored right in the corner.
Well, Clark appears to have a problem somewhere in the knee or ankle. Everson will be the man to go on. Hain has a difficult kick. He grounded this ball less than a metre inside the touchline. That's how much room he had to move in, but Earl Baker has been taking it up all day and he was very effective that time. Hain's kick is not so effective. Gone right across the front of the post. And now the Tigers have it all to do. And gee, they've done some sterling things this year, but then they reach down into the bags in the second half.
Yes, we have a new injury from Wayne Baker there, mate.
So, Baker off. Wayne Clark will be off for the game. Did you say Baker?
Yeah, I said Clark, mate. I said Clark, yeah.
Okay, now here's the kickoff from Aberdeen. It's gone to Hume. Baker it is. On to Baker. The man who had it, picked up and jumped by McGrath. A strong tackle. And he's knocked the ball on. And that was by Huddleston McGrath, I should say.
Aberdeen needed that. That was a big hit by Huddleston. He's made muscle of make error. They've got to capitalise right now, Aberdeen.
Now, Everson gets his touch in the grand final. He'll be on the field now. Feeney, Daniels. Daniels brought down, Cummings lying all over him. He's lucky not to incur a penalty.
It'll be a penalty right. The line was in. There was no move from the by Cummings. And he's right in front of the sticks. Aberdeen and back in this game. They'll put 3 points over here.
I thought Cummings was doing a bit of work on him. Yeah, he certainly did. More than just holding him down.
No, that's what I meant, Brian. There's no need for Cummings to do that.
And he's getting in turn. Very good. That opens up the option. It's Cummings very disappointed. No, 10 minutes for Cummings. And the Rams are down to 12. The Tigers are going to take the kick. It'll put them within range. And now, rugby league, it's a funny game.
I thought he was a bit tough to get 10 minutes Cummings there. He put a little bit in, but I don't think he's worth 10 minutes in a grand final. This could be vital.
I agree with you too, Giggs. I don't think he should have got 10 minutes, but definitely the penalty did deserve to go to Aberdeen.
Now, what's happening now? Over the post. They've battled so hard this year, the Tigers. They'd love to pick this game up today, but gee, they've got a lot of work to do. Phelps, measuring out his run now. An important kick. Could swing the grand final back well to a position where they can attack it. Right in front of the post. Bang! It's away.
That's the 22 for the dropout. But that's not a problem for Aberdeen goalkeeper. He already summed it up pretty well in the preview.
So, blue balls on the field. And the players have all had a good breather from all of that incident. We're going to be finishing pretty late here at Olympic Park 2. If they have extra time, we'll be into the darkness. Payne, big kick taken by Feeney, 32 metres out from the game line onto Huddleston. Huddleston really charging, takes it right up the halfway before they wrestle into the ground. Penalty, McKellar, miss of the arm in the tackle. And Aberdeen have a chance to go right under the attack. Logan will just take a quick tap, runs to Peed, steps through Peed, still going Logan, strong run from the coach, he's only about 32 metres out, that's an 18 metre run, back now to Milton, Fettini, to Smith, Smith flashes Knowles out of a couple of tackles, he drops the ball back, picked up by Milton, knock on by Milton,
good call by the referee, was a fine little knock on there, Brian, it's Tim Kelly's about to take the field too,
so that'll be Upton coming off, Kelly on. And say the Rams do have a leader. Did he go on? I didn't see that in the change. It was pretty quick.
No, he hasn't gone on yet. He's trying to take the field.
Now, fed in by Hume. Hume is tackled by Feeney. The referee has called it back. So we'll have to feed it again. The Tigers have won this. Logan gets up with it. He'll fly it back to Feeney. Feeney will run himself. Won't get very far, but he's inside the 22. Top chance for the Tigers here as it comes across to McGrath. He steps, goes inside, but he'll be thrown to ground about 12 metres out. Now Milton, dummies one way, goes the other, on and goes to himself. Drops his leg down, only about 7 metres to the try line. So the Tigers putting the pressure on. Six to go, I'd say. No, he didn't see that. Daniels. Back to Margaret's going the other way. Margaret's running strongly inside the 22, but a good tackle from Bartholomew. Wade to Daniels. Dummies. Now Feeney. It'll chip through. Face takes it. And he'll be taking himself down in the tackle, but he's just in the field of play.
Well, that's fair enough too, Brian, because a couple of plays of the ball ago, it was knocked on as the halfback was getting the ball out.
And now it's McKellar to play it. 6 metres out from his own line. Howard gets it back now to Peed. Peed's going to be tackled. The Tiger defence has certainly livened up a bit. Peed getting up slowly to play it. Back it comes to Bartholomew. Bartholomew's going to be well and truly held up, wrapped up by two or three players. Back it comes now to Hume. He passes to McKellar. McKellar is thumped to the ground. Another strong tackle from Margaret. And he'll fly it. Back to Howard. Howard will put the kick in. It's a good one coming down near the sideline. Feeney's running back, takes it over his head. Hayne is after him. Hayne looks at him. Feeney does him. He's almost cut. He's up 28 metres out. A good run for the little halfback. I think the Tigers have lifted at the moment. Maybe they're not out of this game. Margaret, how it goes to Huddleston, caught with the ball. This is back to Margaret. He floats it. It's picked up by Smith. Smith's looking to get it away. But pulled down on the 22. He'll play it to Milton. Shoots it away to Daniels. Down the blind side. Daniels gets it away to Pat. Catch is charging. Up goes the ball to Anderson. In ball. No try. Well, I was going by the crowd reaction. Couldn't possibly fair from here.
It was a tough judge that disallowed it. Turnbull thought it was a fair try. He looked at his tough judge and he shook his head. No, Brian, the actual player went over the sideline before he grounded the ball.
Well, he couldn't have gone over the sideline because they're taking a 22 tap.
Touching goal, boy.
And now it comes out to Creed. Creed running and trying out. And Chubb Paul Moore's in. He's been hit. He's got another break. Muswellbrook 13, leading Aberdeen 16.
Ferguson at ARNBM Smith George Street, Singleton, phone 722-003. JK's TV antenna service won't be beaten on price. At the end of this year, new TV services start coming online in the Hunter Valley. But if you're going to enjoy them, most likely you'll need a UHF area. Ring 35 1941 and JK's TV antenna service will look after you. They've been installing areas for 20 years. Remember, they won't be beaten on price. And remember their phone number, 45-1941. They also hire TVs and video recorders. JK's TV antenna service of Stone, 45-1941.
And it's the Rams on the attack. Here loves a big pass out to Moody. Moody steps back inside, but it's Margaret who's got the Alliance wagon to put into the ground. 18 metres out from the Aberdeen try line. The Rams hoping to wrap this up here at the moment. Then it comes to Bartholomew. Dummy steps, gets it back to Moody. Moody's thrown to the ground, still about 16 metres out in the fifth. That was Howard getting up and playing it. Back now to Turner. Turner with a little kick through. It's found the open spaces, but will go right through and go dead in goal. So we're back to normal. Thank goodness. All these dramas. Mark Gagler.
Yeah, McGee, that was courageous defence by the Tigers. They defended stoutly there. I think that little boost fired the Tigers up and looked for a big improvement.
Now Milton takes us up on the 22 to Feeney. Back to Milton. Milton straightens up. And eventually a little drag down by Baker. Gets up, plays it. Back to Feeney. Phelps charges. A good charge from Phelps, brought down about 34 metres out. The Tigers want a little bit of magic at the moment. Back it comes to Smith, just on the charge. That runs well too, brings it up to 5 metres from halfway. He's gone like a beauty since he's gone on there, Smith. Feeney, out it comes to Daniels. Daniels puts a big pass out to Harrison. Harrison drives it back inside to Cleek. Cleek to Daniels. Daniels gets away to McGrath. McGrath is going to be...
He's been for being outside, he's been in, he's got 10 minutes in the bin, Cummins still isn't out there, Aberdeen on the attack.
Did Jim get 10?
Yeah, 10 in the bin.
Oh, it's a shot. Margaret is in. A beautiful shot.
Yeah, McGee, McGee's walking with a bench, he's got 10 in the bin, as I said, that little incident with the cut track has fired the Tigers up.
14 points to 10, the Rams lead.
Being offside, he's been in, he's got 10 minutes in the bin, Cummins still isn't out there, Aberdeen on the attack.
Did Jan get 10?
Yeah, 10 in the bin.
Oh, here's a shot coming up, Margaret is in, a beautiful shot of Aberdeen.
Good.
I think that was a good pass from Daniel, Margaret to Wayne.
It was a brilliant pass, Brian. Getting back to the Hearn thing, it was a professional foul by Hearn, and the referee had no alternative but to send him from the field for 10 minutes. Aberdeen took a quick cut and spun the ball wide, and Ben Dennis had a beautiful pass out to Margaret, and Margaret is in the corner.
It's full time in Sydney at 16-14 in favour of Penrith and Sydney.
Well, the Rams are down to 11 men. Cummings must soon be back on. Here he comes. They're back to 12. They're only up 13 with 11. Cummings is on. And he will rally the troops. The Tigers certainly got the upper hand while he was out of town. This is not back by itself. Picked up by Logan. Gets a big pass away to Huddleston. Not trying to spin it. Oh, Turner went into a big one there. I think Turner's done his ankle. It's back to Everton. Keep an eye on that one, Gibbs. Everton makes ground. He's 24 metres out from his own line. Back it comes now to Daniels. Daniels gets it away to Smith. Smith's got to be held this time. Tackled 31 metres out from his own line. Milton will get the ball to Daniels. Daniels goes for the big pass again to Margaret. Well, goes to Prince. Prince dancing. Gets it back to Bruce. Bruce tries to run it back. Gets it to Phelps. Phelps is running slowly and will eventually be tackled 46 metres out from his own try line.
20 corners coming from the field.
Right, and that's bad luck to Muswellbrook. Everything's gone wrong for them. That's bad. Gone wrong for the Tigers too. As Douglas puts it on the deck. Well, that's bad luck to Turner and to Muswellbrook. He went over on his ankle in that tackle, and now the scrum will pack down. Keep an eye up. It's, well, it's not a bad replacement. Charles Butman. Yes, Tiger. Will he go straight to 5'8"? No, Bartholomew's in 5'8". As they win the scrum, the Rams. It comes to Bartholomew. He's going to be tackled and put to ground by Daniels. Back it comes. We might check out and see how much time to go to, Paul. 22 minutes. Buckman's put it on. 22 minutes. We seem to be going here for ages. McGrath has it.
Oh, no, that's over the top.
What have we got, everyone? Paul Freed. Right across the head. And Freed might be lucky to survive that one. Meanwhile, McGrath's been laying over on his side. We'll take a break. The score here is 13 points to 10 in favour of the Rams in the 1991 Grand Final.
So we still head up here at a lucky pass in Muswellbrook. It's 15 to 10, just recapping through time in Sydney. 16 points to 14, Penrith over North Sydney.
Well, McGrath being taken from the field. Heavy hit there, penalty to Aberdeen. And the replacement going on is Trevor Jones for the Tigers. And there's someone lining up to the close to the Ram outfit too. In fact, he's on. It's Hungerford who's on there. Baker off, Hungerford on. Out it comes now to Bear Logan. Logan's on the charge and will be tackled 44 metres out from the Ram line. Now Smith, the forward's working well for Aberdeen. A good run from Smith. He's almost to the 22 before he's pulled down. On the blind side, it goes now to Daniels. Keeney on the wraparound. Keeney will be wrapped up himself. Still just short of that 22. Huddleston gets it away now to Jones. Jones has had a spell as he's full of life. Now he's inside the 22, that last tackle. Hilton. Daniel steps. He's got to be caught, is he? It'll kick through. And Keeney's there. The ball's loose. And it will be knock on, no play on. Cummings has cleaned it up. That was a bit of good work for Cummings to be back there. And someone might go and check for me how things are going up beyond there, please. Yes. Right, back it comes now to Cummings. Cummings gets it away to Butman. Butman's made a break. And will let me pull down by Preston. Loses the ball. Play on. Preston's running. He's started this. Move the back. Button shot to Huddleston. Huddleston's on the charge. They'll be pulled down about 10 metres out.
Yes, McGrath has severe concussion.
And thank you. Back it comes now to Daniels. Everson. Everson will be taken by the line. And it's come to back down. And just about 10 metres out, or Muswellbrook will have a chance to get this ball. They're certainly under pressure at the moment. And it's run by Aberdeen against the head. Feeney's got it. They reckon now there's pressure here. Feeney's going to go for Daniels. Daniels finding space. Goes beautifully brought down by Moody. Good tackle by the centre. Margaret decides to go himself. He's strong, but he's got to be held out. A strong tackle against from Howard. Now, Milton goes to dummy. Almost rolls himself into the try line. Now, he's still only half a metre out. Big pass. Cleese, another big pass. It's an awful run of Smith. Back to Everson. Everson stepping. Almost stepped his way through, but it's got to be held up by the defence of Buckman, I think. Now, Stark is there.
No, Brian, he's not.
No,
Brian, he's not.
Tigers still haven't got there. 13-10, the score remains.
How much pressure can the Rams take here? I mean, the Tigers are coming home with a wet tail, aren't they?
They certainly are. Still plenty of time left.
Interesting point. There's still 20 minutes of football to be played. Don't panic either side.
And it looks like Scott McGrath is on his feet. They're talking to him, and I think he might be looking as though he's going to go out there again.
He wants to go back on, but they won't let him, McGee.
Well, if he wants to, I reckon they should let him go.
He's fighting the trainers too, mate.
If he wants to, they should let him go. Anyway, here's the Rams down position. Hungerford, take it down in the tackle of Huddleston. That's 32 metres out from his own line. Cummings, showing the ball, stepping back the other way, then getting it away to Kelly, I think it is. Yep, Kelly's back in the game. Still about 32 metres out. Cummings, showing the ball to Bartholomew. Bartholomew rushes to the ground, but got the ball back to Howard. Now to Kelly. Kelly's put the ground about 9 metres short of halfway. Not doing anything fancy now, the Rams. They'll see they've lost their magic with Turner off the field. Cummings, caught. Gets the ball back to McKellar though. He throws it away to Kelly. And Kelly's tackled. 8 metres inside the half. Still with tackles to go. Kelly getting slowly to his feet. That sum would be a bit of a worry for him. Howard, they've got to go himself. Now gets it back to Cummings. Cummings put the kicks in. Cruz will knock it. Backwards is the referee. And he'll be taken down by Cleese. And will we play the ball just outside his own 22. Margaret, Cassini, on it goes to Fentz. Keeps stepping, comes back the other way. All the time, he had his jumper held on to by Hungerford. Now we play it. Cassini with a dummy half, runs himself. Good run from Little Cassini. And he's taken it out about 32 metres. Now Milton. Stops, finally again. Now it's up to the 32 metre mark. Now we'll get it right. Back and comes to Daniels, Margaret. Margaret's looking for his winger, but he'll be taken down by Cummings. 33 metres out, last tackle. Daniels the kick, and it's a bounce. He's got to bounce well to home. He'll give it up. And he'll go down in the tackle. 7 metres inside the half.
Greg Hume's back on the field too, Brian.
So we're back to full numbers now.
Yeah.
As Moody is held in the tackle and taken down 6 metres inside the half. Rams having a bit of trouble getting on the move. Hume, now they might with Hume back there calling the shots. Out it goes to Buckman, he's very fast. He's got a bit of a gap around the outside, but his pass has gone astray and into touch, I think, yes. The flag is up. And the scrum will back down. 13 points to 10. Here's the scoreboard in favour of Muswellbrook in the grand final.
Tigers should have a good opportunity. They've got good field position here, Brian. It's just about halfway.
Yes, if they can make the breaks here, they'll get there. Bruce, extra man here. Out the catch. Chance has got the chance to go close. It's about to Huddleston. Margaret's back inside. They moved it well. Margaret's can't unload now, but he's almost to the halfway mark. Back it comes now to Milton. Milton gets the play to Smith. Smith's got to be held by Cummings. He's pretty balling a fair in there at the moment. As it comes back now to Milton, gets it away to Jones. Jones pops it up, a good pass, and down in the tackle goes Logan, 10 metres inside the Muswellbrook half. Now it's Feeney, Daniels, Cummings back into Feeney, Daniels cuts him up, but he's going to be caught. Still about 30 metres out from the try line, and tackles running out for the Tigers. Bruce, on it comes to Feeney, back to Bruce, Bruce Cummings, now goes, he stands it back.
We'll be right back.
commercial
help. Running out to the Tigers. Sluice. When it comes to Feeney. Back to Sluice. Sluice dummies. Now goes. He stands it back. Little kick. And the ball is going to bounce beautifully for
him. It's a try.
French has scored. No doubt about that. And just the Tigers are in front. They lead by 14 points to 13 with about 12, 13 minutes to go in the grand final.
Gee, I reckon Paul, if I look at this kick, he's going to put that to the left of the face. I might be wrong. But great bit of work by Cleese.
Little Mick Cleese did it all that time, Brian. He got the ball there. There wasn't real lot on. He made the break. He took the ball heavy. He was unlucky not to score himself. But Robert French was the first player there. He scored a great try.
Well anticipated by French, I thought. Now Phelps. It's only 1 point in at the moment, 14-13. He's put it to the... And had a few spots of rain falling through. One more to go, Jiggs. Check it out.
There's 14 minutes left to go. McGee takes Kelly's off. Dallas Buckman off. Muffet made a few changes.
Who's on? Gill?
Steve Baker's been picked back on. They're using the interchange and third anchor. We're getting safe.
Oh, they're pretty heavy drops at the moment. And Muswell has to come back as Hayes puts a low one down. Kelly takes it. Just outside of his own line. The little halfback runs it up to the court. And we'll be pulled down by Howard on the 42. Got a crowd of there. Threshold 15 minutes, 14 minutes to go. As we see Phelps running. And he'll go down. Knocks it out of fight. He's cutting it out about 28 metres from the Aberdeen line. Back to Daniels. Daniels will be tackled 33 metres out from the Aberdeen line. Daniels now will get it back to Milton. On it goes to Smith. Smith makes good ground. Looking to get the ball away. He's still going forward before Hungerford picks him up and puts him on the ground 7 metres from halfway. Now back it comes to Phelps. Phelps will take it up to the halfway mark. And now I'd say we'll look to Daniels to put the kick in. Back it comes to him. So the chase is on good for him. Now he puts it up. And down across the base. Base takes it down just outside his 22. Margaret will take him down in the clock hole. And it's Hain. Hain looking for a bit of a break, but goes down easily in the tackle of Margaret. Now, Howard turns back on there, so his ankle's okay. They really need him out there. Cummings goes down in the tackle 10 metres from halfway. Hume, Turner, onto Baker. Baker got the ball.
Tackle by Milton. About 4 metres short of the halfway mark. And this time it's Hume. Big pass off the hand. Getting from the smoke. Now he's going to stop. Kick it back to Kane. Kane looking. Kane's got the way. He gets it away. The man
blew out. Back to Baker. It's Kane's pulling pass. Puts it on the banana. Now Hayne. The pitch back in. Kick. It's up to the ball. Kane. Back in business. And about 25 metres out from the Aberdeen line. We still have about 10 metres left to play. To the Scotland team's hurt. Well,
the mortality rate is tremendous. In my ears, the company has changed the money.
Margaret will put the chip over the top. Makes running for it. Takes it beautifully or did he knock it on? No, it's gone. Eventually to Reynolds, I think.
This will really knock it back down.
And Reynolds will play it. And it'll be here, he'll run. And he'll be tackled too. Hit by Jones. 28 metres out from the Muswellbrook line now. Cut it. Looking to get away. Pops it. Awkwardly. But it's going to be an Aberdeen ball. Dumps will fall on it. And cut it. And my ears have suddenly got some peace as
The rain has affected some of our gear here. Here's Daniels running. A very elusive run. Everton cuts back infield to avoid the sideline and brought down about 35 metres out. Please, gets it away out of Smith. Smith's got to be tackled by Hungerford. Puts it away to Little Mickey Peace. Keeney on the charge. Almost up to the 22. And that's where he'll play it. Still tackles to go. How many, I don't know. Back it comes to Daniels. Daniels a big one out to Phelps. Phelps can't pull out of the tackle. Got it back to Jones. Jones will be held in the tackle. But makes a few more yards anyway. And still tackles to go for the Tigers. As it comes out to Daniels. Daniels are losing, stepping, losing. The Bates will grab him. Only 5 metres out. Margaret's waving. Send it out here. Say the Cruz goes the other way. Everton has popped the ball in the touch. What a good diving tackle.
Great tackle there by Shane Hayes.
So I think Nicky Cruz went the wrong way there. Ought to come the open. Margaret was screaming for the ball.
Certainly was. That wouldn't have been Shane Hayes. Must have been Reggie Reynolds.
Reggie Reynolds, sorry.
Yeah. Now, fed in by Muswellbrook. They've got a chance to get away from here. They do. It comes to Turner. Turner running okay now. It goes bouncing down to Moody. Moody's tackled, though, eventually by Margaret after Logan slowed it up. Hume on to Turner. Looks good already with Turner out there. And, Haynes stopped. He thought the whistle had gone. And now he's hit the ground. Well, Haynes stopped far too much for my liking. Hume. Away it comes now to Turner. To Baker. Baker will pop the pass. It finds its mark in Turner. And Turner's ready to deliver to it. And this is bouncing down towards the Aberdeen 32. And we're going to touch in fact 3 metres out from the Aberdeen skyline. At the tight.
And so still got as big as 10, 9, 11.
7 minutes to go.
And the Tigers are taking a bit of a spell here. They've been under pressure.
Well, this game, Petey. Petey takes it. Petey still running. A beautiful run. Over halfway. Will hang on to the ball. And he'll play it back to Milton. Muswellbrook having trouble getting back. Now French, he likes his broken play running. But he's well caught by Hume. Milton in the running half. The Tigers have a strike back chance here again. As it goes from Cruz to Daniels to Margaret. Margaret's only changes pace. He was looking to pass, then changed pace, but he was well caught in the tackle by McKellar, who's done a lot of covering for the Rams today. Back it comes to Daniels. Daniels puts a high kick up. Here goes Nicky Cruz. Break the ball base. Makes the circuit. Everton will flip it up. And the Aberdeen players have kicked the ball. That could have been the ball game there. Oh, and they've knocked it on. Milton's knocked it on. And so.
And that's a very tough call, John.
And we have Douglas coming off. And, Douglas has done a lot of tackling. I don't know whether I've brought him off yet. And it's Bocchi on. Well, Bocchi was here in 1987 when the Tigers scored that magnificent victory over the Rams, 24-12 here. Tigers lead 14-13. And they have a kick to come. And that's with 5 minutes to go in the grand final. Well, they're ringing in the changes as Phelps lines up his kick. Kelly coming back on for Hungerford. Putman back on for Reggie Reynolds. They're taking him off the field, the winger. And Phelps lining up this kick that could give that all-important three-point barrier. And according to my clock, 5 minutes left in the grand final. It is a vital kick. And let's face it, Chelsea hasn't had the boots on today.
Well, probably because he's got to keep one centre or later, Brian.
Well, I think there's a lot of people over there, black and gold. Look how silent they are over there.
There's a hush right down the ground, isn't there?
There is a hush. It's one of those pregnant moments. I think he's got it, mate. Right away. No, the battle remains, but the Tigers still lead, 14 points to 13. Haynes would take the dropout, and Mike Rock says 4 minutes to go in the grand final. So the kick at least,
Takes up a few minutes as it comes up to Feeney. Feeney now will run. He runs straight into Moody. Moody takes him down about 6 metres on the Aberdeen side of halfway. Played back now to Milton. Emerson. Emerson runs into the forwards, runs into plenty of problems there too. Milton, but it comes to Logan. Can he put another big run on here? Taken down by Baker and by Cummings. Cummings has got to his work today. Even though I feel he's not 100%. Back it comes now. Hungerford goes to the intercept. It comes to Huddleston. Huddleston's made a good run over halfway. Now 12 metres inside the Muswellbrook half. And Huddleston's taking some time to get to his feet. I think it could be just taking up the seconds. Now Bock. Oh, Bock. Bock looking like a legend there. Takes about 8 metres upfield. Last tackle. It'll come to Daniels. Daniels puts the kick and chase up. More pressure for Bate. They're riding with him. It's got to be a penalty. Yes, that's right.
And that's fair enough too, Brian.
Opening the mouth. I'd say they were yapping at him. That's what he's saying. Trying to put him off. And that is not part of the game. Emerson thought he might have been able to pull that penalty in. Well, now the acid test. 3 minutes out from full time. Tigers one in front. The Rams with a penalty on attack. 6 tackles from halfway. Baker led back. Charges in. The Tigers put him down. 39 metres out. So the Rams have 39 metres of pressure. The covering five. Out of comes to power. Abu Bartholomew. To young Buckman. Buckman almost gets away. That is Daniels who puts him down. 32 metres out. Cummings away to Turner. Where's the magic now? It goes to the pass and Peter's gone nowhere. And the new player on the wing over there, it's Moody. Moody's with it up. And it comes out of Bartholomew. Holds the pass.
Great.
A beautiful tackle. A beautiful tackle from Logan. But it comes out of him. Pass inside to Turner. Turner down the gap. No, he didn't. But it comes to home. And doesn't know what to do. He gives it to Mattel. He knows what to do. And he's tackled 25 metres up. Last tackle for the Rams. Cummings will put up the big kick. And now it's Mickey Cleese under pressure. And he takes it. It'll be a 22 cap. There's 1 minute to go.
McGill, I thought they would have took an option and dropped the field goal. Look for extra time.
Well, they didn't. I don't know why they didn't. What? 1.5 to go it is. And the Tigers have 6 tackles. They'll try and hold it for the 6 and put it well downfield. As Feeney takes it up, and that should have been a penalty too, but what was he not blamed by referee there? Milton makes it up to 11 metres from halfway. Keith felt important that he has a good run, but can't get too far. Howard's had a tremendous game with his defence from the marker spot. Now to Jones. Jones has got to make it to halfway. Very well done before that man McCullough puts him down again. Jones getting up slowly. He'll play it back to Smith. On it comes to Cruz. Cruz takes a little skippy hop. Makes another meter before he's put down. Quick time. Quick tackle. Marcus decides to run. And gets it back now to Feeney. Feeney will kick. He's put it over Haynes. And here comes Huddleston on the ball. And there's a game in his hand. And it goes to Moody. Moody's a lead of the couple. He's short yarded on the way. Now it's Sabatella. There's 13 in the line. And it goes to Batman. Batman carrying up ball. He gets forward in the touch. And the Tigers are the champions from 1991. They have won by 14 points to 13.
This month, QMM focuses on Singleton. Singleton's passion for sport is well catered for, with facilities about 2 times for better. While the talent effort from the Royals football code is well documented, there are facilities for many other sports. The town-based lawn tennis facilities, grounds for cricket, hockey and soccer, a superb swimming and fitness centre and basketball stadium. The town's current golf course is soon to be complemented by a new 18-hole layout. Add this to the array of water sports, martial arts and physical culture catered for, and you begin to see that Singleton really is a town for good sports.
This 2AM focus on Singleton has been brought to you by Pengelly's Health Centre.
The complete sportsman store is Leo's Sports Scene in Bridge Street, Muswellbrook. Leo's Sports Scene carry a great range of sporting gear as well as fishing tackle and sports clothes. There's also a large range of footwear to fit all sizes and most sports are catered for. At Leo's Sports Scene, Bridge Street, Muswellbrook, you get personal service and advice from Leo and Judy. When shopping for sporting equipment and clothes in Muswellbrook, the greatest range is at Leo's Sports Scene, just up from Mitre 10 in Bridge Street, Muswellbrook.
Full time at Olympic Park. It's the Tigers' day here in the grand final for 91. Brian.
Well, a mass of people milling around. We're trying to get onto a few of them. Mark Douglas might be able to get onto the bicycle and get out there. We have the Muswellbrook RSL Man of the Match Award to give away. And my word, what a challenge that will be to pick the player most deserving. There were some good ones on both sides of the fence. And while we're waiting to see if we can clear the ruck to bring you our man, Paul Giro, run us through the stats on the game.
What an amazing game that day that's done. Yeah. 2-7 in favour of Muswellbrook, Aberdeen as well. The penalties were 9 all. The errors, 14 errors, and Aberdeen made 11. There were two handovers, and both times Aberdeen handed the ball over to Muswellbrook. The try scorers for today, McPeed scored in the 33rd minute, and Shane Haynes scored in the 44th minute, and Ewan Bartholomew kicked a field goal, and for
Shane Haynes, kicked 2 out of 4.
2 out of 4, right. And in the, for Aberdeen, the victors, Mark Feeney scored in the 24th minute, Rod Margaret scored in the 55th minute, and Robert French scored in the 67th minute, and Jason Felt kicked 1 goal from 6 attempts.
Right, thank you very much. And of course, in those second half scrum stats, very importantly, 2 tight heads. And David White, 3 tight heads. 3 tight heads in the second half for Milton. That's a fine performance. Well, we'll be trying to get people here with us in a moment to see how they're going. But a great victory to Aberdeen. But a pretty
tough. Yes, Brian. Can you hear me there, Brian? Yes, we have Ewan Bartholomew. Ewan, great game, and it was very close to
Brian Huddleston. Yeah, it was a pretty tough game out there. All I want to do is win it for our fans. And they come out good, and I just thought if he's had a great ball over, he's been a really good coach, and he's got us all wrong.
So, Ewan, yeah, you're underdogs at the beginning of the year. You come out, you're taking the grand final by 1 point.
Yeah, I think we're celebrating the Tigers in our week.
Okay, mate, have a good night.
Thanks.
Be a disappointed man. The Rams would be very disappointed. I thought Paul, they put up a top effort out there today.
It was an amazing effort. Brian, it was an amazing day here at Olympic Park at Muswellbrook, and it was an amazing game of football, and what a great climax it is to the Footy's Good 21 Rugby League season.
Yes, and I'll say a bit more about it later. Mark Douglas might just have someone lined up at the moment.
Yes, we do. I've got Ben Daniels here with me. Ben, what do you think of that game, mate?
Oh, she was awfully close and awfully hard. I'd, you know, just glad it's over and we won.
It was a fast game, wasn't it? Do you think you were beaten at any stage?
Oh, no, we knew we could play better and we just hope we come back.
You played as a team, didn't you? You played for the bloke next to you today. It really shone out.
Yeah, well, you know, we're all mates on the side. There's, you know, no one we don't like on the side.
Righto, mate, I'll let you go and party all day and night. Thanks, Ben. Yeah, thank you very much, Mark. And of course, right now we have Captain Coach of the Muscle Side, Tim Kelly. Tim, it's very disappointing to lose by 1 point.
Yeah, mate, it is disappointing. You know, it's, you know, I got hurt, I broke my thumb early in the first half, mate, and just, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, you were off and on like a yo-yo there at one stage.
Yeah, mate, I thought it'd be all right, but it wasn't, you know. It just, the side, they didn't give up. Aberdeen didn't give up either. Full credit to them, mate, they come back, you know, and that's the way football is.
Well, a very good year indeed, in anyway, mate.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
As you can see there, that's the, I suppose, the very sad thing about green final. Someone has to lose. Maybe in many ways, Muswellbrook very unlucky today to lose. We're going to get our Muswellbrook RSL Man of the Match with us very shortly. We'll find him somewhere. And our Muswellbrook RSL Man of the Match will have to get very shortly to us. And I'll be talking to him very soon. But what a tremendous day it has been in terms of the grand finals here today. And Aberdeen, they have been a side all the year who have battled and fought their way through to the top. And first of all, I've got the captain coach of the Tigers here, Bear Logan. Bear, congratulations, a great effort.
Thank you, everyone.
And on behalf of our group here too, and the Muswellbrook RSL, there a little additional thing for the group here. Our panel have voted you Man of the Match, Grand Final Day 1991. Well done. You must be absolutely stuck full of emotion at the moment.
It's a Well, 22 year old, what are you going to be able to do when you grow up, mate? No, couldn't be able to go. Yeah, well, putting that out there today, there, you've got your side too, absolutely tremendous. Anyone you'd like to thank for the whole thing? Just a prize, you know, you got to the tournament, it's football in the all year.
Been a secretary side, just had great spirit and that togetherness they have.
Yeah,
it's good. Steve, you've done a wonderful job. You're a local boy, you're a youngster. You've come through. Your boys are the heroes of your town. Even if they'd have lost today, they'd have still been the heroes of the town. But they've come through with the bacon after coming from behind. Congratulations, you've got a wonderful year, and we'll have your Muswellbrook RSL prize ready. I'll bring it to you in the shed shortly. Well done, Bear Logan. And Mark Gagler, who have we got over there now?
Hello, Gagler, with me, the boys, don't you?
The grand final.
Mate, I thought it was a legendary game of football. There were some beautiful decisions in it that it could go either way. But I thought the most memorable thing in this game was Troy Logan's tackle on Ewenbark on the 25 metres out from his own line. That will live in my memory for many a long day, Magoo.
You made the right choice of man of the match, Becker.
Did I? Yeah, it certainly is. It was an outstanding performance. And just closely followed by Mark Burney. They were absolutely everything. But I really did believe that it was a super performance by Troy Logan.
Yeah, there's a super performance out there for a lot of players. There'll be a lot of people who disagree with us, but that's the way it is. There are so many good players. Milkshake Milton, I see his mother over there. She left his camp, 3 point heads in the second half, and he was at work all day. And now I think we're seeing the players get their medallions for the grand final. Mark Feeney. What a tremendous game. He certainly turned into our calculations, but Trevor James, his last game. And he's going out a winner again. He's been the club captain this year and has been a great assistance to Bill Logan.
He's had a big game for the game, McGee.
Yeah. Jason Fox, player of the year, a great one. Tell me, if Scott McGrath went out to get his, is he taking it? Thanks, Mark Penny, great one.
Don't worry, McGee, you won't be compared.
He's got a performance in tackling. So Scott McGrath is here and he will come up to get his medal. Greg Law, very handsome to him, very sore looking, but Paul Smith came on as a replacement and did extremely well as he has done all year.
I'd like to see your haircut on next year and then next Saturday like your son's gone.
There's no way I'll do that. He ran into a rough one and a tough one, didn't he?
Certainly did, but he had an outstanding game.
The Tigers, that's it. They've all got their medallions by courtesy of twos and you see, it looks like we're running out of bother. We'll have a last race and everyone, as the fellows can travel around over here. We'll hear first of all, Paul Bankovic, lasting memories of Green Friday Day 1991.
Mate, it was a solid game of football and it, I thought perhaps the game could have went either way. Jason Fox missed those two easy shots at goal. That could have been a turning point, but I really did believe that in the last 15 minutes the Aberdeen Tigers tackled like they've never tackled before in the year, and I do believe that that one in the game must have had to throw the ball around, and unfortunately they didn't come up with a good, but it was a super game and a good performance by the Aberdeen Tigers.
God, Jacob Bright.
Number of turning points during the game, but realistically I always thought Aberdeen would always hit the better side in the second half. They threatened the score, we passed our minds back. They did have two tries, one was disallowed, and I think double movement on Jason Phelps. But Aberdeen were by far the better side in the second half. And as Paul just said, Aberdeen's defence was very strong. But this final, the one thing that sticks in my mind, as far as the turning point concerned, when Shane Haynes kicked towards the end of the game, Nick Cross knocked it on, and Aberdeen won the scrum against the feed. But that virtually sealed Muswellbrook's fate.
A good comment, Paul Giro, the little worm from Millwall.
Well, Aberdeen were the better side in the day. The scoreboard says they were. Muswellbrook were unfortunate on a few different occasions. Their injuries didn't help them. Johnny Turner was off the field. Ken Kelly, as we said earlier, he broke his thumb very early in the game. Things didn't quite go Muswellbrook's way this way. But good sides made their own luck, and Aberdeen made their own luck. And they really did come back into the game. But a lot of lesser teams would have folded down. But listen, I'm with Benko on that hit that when Bear Logan hit Ewenbark on you. It was just at a crucial time in the game,
and it really inspired the other Tigers, and that really...
Bill Logan made a great run too there at one stage to inspire them. Mark Gagler.
I think Aberdeen, when they got their try disallowed too, was a fine performance. They thought the ref, the touch overs against them. They really rallied then. It was a great team performance. I thought Muswellbrook were very courageous in defeat. They were unlucky. I thought Cummings was stiff to spend time in the bin for his infringement. Then their casualties to go down by 1 point. Courageous effort.
Right, and if you had only just tuned in, thank you very much. Wow, well, what a beautiful play of the match award it is. Here, Logan's going to be happy with that. If you've just tuned in, Paul Gio, give us the full rundown of the board today.
It's been a super day here today. In the under-16s, Quindai 24, Aberdeen 20. In under-18s, Stan 23, Singleton 12. In the third grade, Muswellbrook Sharks 14, Muswellbrook 10. In reserve grade, it was Stone 29, Singleton 22, and that's just repeating in the first grade here today, Aberdeen 14, Muswellbrook 13.
And every side that won last week has won today. The major semi-final winners have all gone down today. That's quite a turnaround. Well, I'd like to sum it up. Congratulations to Muswellbrook today. They were certainly courageous. But there's no question in my mind that the Aberdeen Tigers' performance this year has been an eye-opener. Young coach, young side, everyone wrote them off, and they have come home strong. They just got there today, but well, it could have gone either way, but they got there through their grit, their guts, and their determination. And they are an outfit that has been doing that all the year. Well deserved. I'd like to say at this stage, thank you to all the guys who've been in the team this year. David Wright, the little rooster, the shattered saint, Paul Benkovic, Paul Giro, the little woman for Bill Law, Mark Gagler, the old sea turkey, Denny Dionis back in the studio, Paul Speziale, who was with us earlier in the year, and of course also the late Angus Peebles, also Henry Page, who did the stats for today and has been helping here. I'd like to thank all the clubs for what's been a very cooperative year in terms of information and teams, and also to all our listeners out there, and of course to my wife and family at home, who put up with me being away all the time. Although I must say, with the football this year, following the football with the Tigers, it's been very enjoyable for both Noel and I, and we've made a lot of friends following the young Tigers around. It's been great being with you for the grand final, great victory for Aberdeen here today, and rugby league itself didn't do too bad out of the whole affair either. Thank you very much for being with us. We're happy back.
Slashed and torn.